Okay, so, hi. I didn't oopsies last time because I did not go over the basics. So yeah, that's what we will do today. So scripting. So anyways, so basically, there's different types of, well, nodes. There's action nodes. They have a cube. There's task nodes, they're like this. Compare, you know, pretty obvious, they compare stuff. Control flow, set like loops and delays, you know, that stuff, right? Events, these have a lightning bolt, and when they happen, something happens. Input. You can reference stuff like arrays, so yeah, which are just, you know, blah. It says right there. There is also references, which are just hashtags, and you can hash reference stuff. It's like you hashtag something, you know. I don't have Twitter. Let's see, what else is there? There's math. It's pretty much just adding, it's an action of the thing. Math 3 is just 3D math. Uses float 3s instead of just floats. Other, you know, more actions. Strings, yeah, so concat, whatever. It's for words and stuff. Variables, you have to add them. You can set them to different kinds of references, which are these, inputs. Yeah, so you put health and then set to that stuff. So it can act like a reference node, but it also can change. So, I'll start with these guys. The events. I guess, like, simply the start. So, with that, whenever you start the game, it plays whatever string is connected to it. So, if you just, like, start, and then you don't want the player to spawn where you put them, you just have a teleport, which is an action node. So you connect to action node, and you need a reference for unit, which is here, and you also need a reference for a position. But in this case, it's a float 3, so there's a few kind of things like floats. So there's floats. There's float 3, which is just 3 floats. And then XYZ. And then there's integers. Just count health. Well, oh wait, no. Yeah. There's strings. You can type numbers, I guess. And then let's see what's up. There's rules. Not really relevant. So floats, these can be, you know, positive, negative, decimals, integers, whole numbers, positive, negative, and strings, text, or letters. Or numbers. Anyways, so yeah. If you wanted to, like, turn an integer, which I'm not sure why you have it, you would need to use a cast node. So maybe into float. So then you can have integers. And then it becomes a float, which add f means adding float, so float. Then yeah, can add, because this is now float. Very interesting. Yeah, so if for a reference note, if it has one of these or that, this one, it lets you select a point for where you want to set the float through. So if I want it there, then it automatically sets it. Or I can type a number and a number. For this though, you can, so you have to like put a unit down or a player. It can be anything, really. And then you have to reference that. Yay. When you start it, get it teleported somewhere. Let's see. So yeah, that's usually for references, actions, and then this button, the mats. So let's see, cast. Actually, now let's do variables. So if you want to like replace a unit, you pretty much do thingamajig. Replace. And then actually you want to set this to a unit first. This is the variable 0. Or you could rename it whatever you want. So instead of doing that, you would have set variable 0 to unit at the start. And then just get variable. And then there's probably some more complex things you could do. Because if you wanted to have like a unit switch weapons, yeah, you could probably do that. It'd just be a bit more, but yeah, let me just get this done with first. And then unit ID, which is a reference for what unit you want to replace it with. So it's not a direct unit, but it's just what kind of unit. So if I want light armored ancient knives, then yeah, do that. Keep tags for, doesn't really matter. And then, yeah, so this will be the new unit, so you want to set variables. You want to set this one so that you can replace it again. And then have start, and then delay, which is used for the time control, or whatever it's called, control flow. And then you're gonna have it wait amount of seconds, which is in floats, so I can have it in 5 seconds. And then I can get the variable again. And then, yeah, it shows me the unit, so then I can actually replace them back to... I can replace this guy back into here. Or actually, you could, if you wanted a random unit, you can use this, because it's random is just integers, always. Random F would be random float, random C is random color, which is, you know, RGB stuff, so. Anyways, so you start, actually, we could put that up there, so, yeah, we can delete that. And then, yeah, how many units are there? Let's just put 1 in 100. Sure. There's way more than that, trust me. Okay, so you can use Cass right now for. And then, yeah, that can pretty much be used here. So actually, rather than doing that, you can simplify it. So, then you need to do that, of course. And then, I don't know, if you still plan on doing that, then you can set the variable. So, and then yeah, so that pretty much just switches them into some random dude after 5 seconds, and yeah, I guess we can test it. Better work, but who knows? It's not gonna work this time. Yeah, but hey, it did replace them. So. There's a chance that it works, and I'm the one teaching you, so it better work. So yeah, it starts in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm stuck. Anyways, yeah, so that's how it works. So if you actually wanted to change it, keep changing it back and forth, you could do it with 2 variables. You can have this. Endless loop. And then float. And then, so you set and get. Yeah, so that's just the starting stuff. So you want to set it first. And you want to get always. And then, instead of doing that, you have an equals. And then you need a few more. And then ifs. If false, then false. I should probably reorganize this, but who cares? I think I know what I'm doing. If I only have 2, then I just do it like this. But if I have 3, I can have another if false. It's just thinking. That's fine. And then, if true, place. If it's again false, which, I wouldn't suggest a unit having more than 3 weapons anyways. Just, you know. You can't even carry 3. What do you expect this guy to do? Not sure if it's vague, but yeah. So the target will always be this guy, because it's the one you get. Then you need. Doing this for some reason. You'll always have to set it back because you'll always be getting said unit. Okay, so this is knife light armor. Let's do bow. A good weapon. Let's do baseball bat, sure. Okay. So, right now, we're missing something. Well, all the bees, obviously, but. We could do this with a float, we could also do this with an integer, so, like, floats. Zero works, sure. And then, yeah. So then, at the end, I could have a second variable. I need this to be a float, and then I have to set variable 1 to a float, because yes, sure, 0. And then, obviously, because you have to make sure it works, it has to be wired correctly, but, yeah, so I have to get variable 1 now. It doesn't just work magically. I wish. Okay, so yeah. After this, it goes into here, and then into here. If it's true, then it replaces. If it's false, then it goes here. If it's true, then it replaces. If it's false, it also replaces. So, right now, if it's a certain variable, it'll be stuck there forever, which is perfect. So, we need to also set variable 1, or actually, get variable 1, and then we just add f, obviously, because float by 1, and then, because I'm lazy, and you probably are too, do this. Or you could not do that. Okay, you probably should not do that. That you should do. Well, if we keep doing that with the third one, then, what'll happen? It won't work anymore. Because, it'll just keep looping at the bottom. So, yeah, you have to set variable 1 into float 0, yes. height is, right? Yeah. So, do you think this would work? You better. I better. Nobody knows. But, hey, yeah. You can clearly see that it's working. Albeit, you know. Yeah. But it's working, nevertheless. So, I'd consider it a success. Yeah. So, let's see. Have I not gone over anything? That's basic. There's different types of events, I guess. Like, there's, I guess, mainly there's start, update, and then, yeah, you might want to be careful with that. So, there's also, if you have a trigger, you have a, on enter, I cannot spell. So you, or exit, which is whenever something goes in or goes out of the box. Now there's one death. It's like once something dies, it triggers. So, you could always do that with like a zombie and then spawn explosion there. I don't know if that works. There's a few interesting ones. There's like on fire. No, that is. On attack, or like, jump, when you jump, on, click, just a lot of stuff. I guess there's also a few nice actions of something. Actions. There's like explosion, which spawns an explosion. There's spawn unit. There's spawn bullet, which can shoot something at someone or somewhere. You can set target position, whatever suits you. Set target position makes a unit walk there, set target makes a unit attack something. There's get target, which is actually pretty useful. You can make some pretty cool stuff with that. There's some guy walking into a bunch of stuff. Compare, I guess. Kind of showed how that could be used. There's better uses, I guess. Yes, there's teleport, which is pretty useful. Raycast, if you want. Yes, there's just adding stuff left, which is also useful for like math stuff. I love it. What else is there? There's game mode. That's useful. Oh yeah, you can add bullets, add money, bleed shield, bleed support, bleed weapon drop, all of that stuff. I guess you know, just like have on hit. So like on damage for player. that would be fun. It's pretty much it for the basics. We've gone over everything from all I can know. Except for just some stuff with dialogue, but it's pretty far. Yeah. of where we are. And save that for button stroke. So, yeah. Thanks for watching. I guess, like, subscribe, do whatever. There's a lot of spam, so, yeah. Thanks for watching. I'm sorry about the inactive widgets on the side, because too lazy to delete them. I might stream later. So, yeah. That is it.